In this video, I'm continuing on with the segment lengths and circles worksheet on the CUDA software website, picking up where we left off on the second page. Now, we're going to be finding the measure of the line segment indicated, and we're going to assume that lines which appear to be tangent are tangent. So now, as opposed to solving for x, we're going to solve for x, and then plug that back in to solve for the segment. And number 9, we're looking for segment UW, and that is 12 plus 2x plus 5. So if that's equal to 12 plus 2x plus 5, 12 plus 5 is 17, and then we're still adding 2x. So UW is equal to 17 plus 2x. So now we're going to solve for x and plug that in. Well, because this is an intersection of chords, a portion of the chord, so U to C, 12 times C to W, 2x plus 5, is going to be equal to the portion of the other chord, 14, times that remaining portion, C to V, of 2x plus 2. And if you're confused on this formula at all, please refer back to the previous video or the first page of this worksheet. And if you need further explanation, leave a comment below. So what I'm going to do is distribute the 12, and I'm going to distribute the 14. 12 times 2x is 24x, plus 12 times 5 is 60. And that's equal to 14 times 2x, which is 28x, plus 14 times 2, which is 28. Subtracting 24x from both sides, I'll get that 60 is equal to 4x plus 28. Then I'll subtract 28 from both sides. 60 minus 28 is equal to 32. So if 32 equals 4x, that means that when I divide by 4, I'll get that 8 is equal to x. So now that I know that value of x, I can plug that value in for x for UW. So plugging 8 in, I'll have 17 plus 2 times 8. So that's 17 plus 2 times 8, which is 16, which will be equal to 33. So 33 is the length of UW in number 9. And number 10, I'm finding the length K to M, so this entire secant length. And notice that this is an intersection of secants. So the entire secant length, MK, 3 plus 2x plus 5, multiplied by that external secant length of MK, 3, that's going to equal the entire length of the secant MW, which is 4 plus 2, times that external length MN of 4. Now I'm going to simplify and then distribute. 3 plus 5 is 8, so I'll have 8 plus 2x within my parentheses, and that's going to get multiplied to 3, and then 4 plus 2 is 6, and that will be multiplied to 4. So now, distributing my 3, so 3 times 8 is 24, plus 2x times 3 is 6x, and that's going to be equal to 6 times 4, which is 24. So now, when I subtract 24 from both sides, I'll get that 6x is equal to 0. And dividing by 6, I'll get that x is equal to 0. However, we're trying to find the length of KM, and KM is 3 plus 2x plus 5. That is KM. So if I plug in x of 0 in for that, I'll get 3 plus 2 times 0 plus 5. So that's 3 plus 0 plus 5, which is equal to 8. So my answer in number 10 is 8. In number 11, I have a secant tangent. So for this, the entire secant length, x minus 3 plus 16, over the tangent x plus 3, is going to equal the tangent x plus 3 over the secant length without the chord, which is simply x minus 3. So my next step will be to cross multiply. So I'll have x minus 3 times x minus 3 plus 16, and that's going to be equal to x plus 3 times x plus 3. So I'm going to distribute my x to each of the terms, and then I'm going to distribute 3 to each of the terms. So x times x is x squared minus x times 3, which is 3x, plus x times 16, which is 16x, minus 3 times x, 3x, plus 3 times 3, since subtracting a negative is the same as adding a positive, 9, minus 3 times 16, which is 48. That is going to be equal to x squared plus 3x plus 3x plus 9. And that's FOILing out first, outside, inside, last. So now I'm going to combine like terms. I'll have x squared, and then I'm going to combine 3x, 16x, and 3x. So 16x minus 3x is 13, and then when I'm subtracting another 3x, I'll get a positive 10x, and then I'll combine 9 and 48. 9 minus 48 is equal to negative 39. So x squared plus 3x minus 39 is going to equal x squared plus 3x plus 3x is 6x, and then I'm still adding 9. Now I'm going to subtract x squared from both sides. And doing this, my x squared will cancel out. So I'll have 10x minus 39 equal to 6x plus 9. 10x minus 39 equals 6x plus 9. Then I'll subtract 6x from both sides. And at the same time I do this, I'll add 39 to both sides. So 10x minus 6x is 4x, and that's going to be equal to 9 plus 39, which is 48. So then, when I divide both sides by 4, I'll get that x is equal to 48 divided by 4, which is 12. So if my value of x is 12, then I'm going to take that x value and plug it in for n, m. And n to m, or m to n, was x plus 3. So I'll have 12 plus 3, which is 15. So because I took that value of 12 and plugged it in for x, I got that 15 was equal to nm. In number 12, I have an intersection of secants. So we're finding the measurement of nl, which is x minus 8 plus 4. Simplifying that, x minus 8 plus 4 is x minus 4. So the entire length of nl is x minus 8 plus 4. That will get multiplied by that exterior secant length of 4. That's going to be equal to the entire length of secant SL, which is x minus 5 plus 3 times that exterior length of 3. So simplifying, I'll have x minus 4 times 4, that quantity times 4, equal to x minus 2, that quantity times 3. So now I'm going to be distributing my 4, and I'm going to distribute my 3. 4 times x is 4x, minus 4 times 4 is minus 16. That's equal to 3 times x, 3x, minus 3 times 2, 6. I'll subtract 3x from both sides to get that x minus 16 equals negative 6. And then I'll add 16 to both sides to get that x is equal to negative 6 plus 16, which is 10. So if x is 10, I'm going to take that value of 10 and plug it in for x for the measure of nl. So that's 10 minus 4, which equals 6. So 6 is the length of nl in number 12. In number 13, again, I have an intersection of secants. I'm finding CE, which is 2x minus 17, the length of C to D, plus the length of D to E, 9. Simplifying, 2x minus 17 plus 9 is equal to 2x minus 8. So that entire secant length, C to E, 2x minus 17 plus 9, multiplying that by that external length of 9, will equal the entire length of SE, which is 10 plus 8, times that external secant length, FE, of 8. Simplifying, 2x minus 8 times 9 equals 10 plus 8, 18 times 8. I'll distribute the 9 to the 2x and 8. So 9 times 2x is 18x minus 9 times 8, 72, will be equal to 18 times 8, which is 144. So adding 72 to both sides will help me isolate my x term. So 18x will be all by itself, and that's equal to 144 plus 72, which gives me 216. And dividing by 18 will give me my value of x. 216 divided by 18 is 12. Now I can take that value of x and plug it in for my x to find the measurement of CE. So 2 times 12 minus 8 equals CE. 2 times 12 is 24 minus 8 is 16. So 16 is my solution in number 13. In number 14, I have an intersection of chords, and I'm going to be using that to find the segment length. The segment length I'm looking for is CA. That is equal to 14 plus 3 plus 3x. Now remember, the portions of the chords will multiply together to equal the portions of the other chord. So I'll have 14 times 3 plus 3x, that's C to L times L to A, will equal D to L, 12, times L to B. D to L times L to B, which LB is 4x plus 1. So I'll distribute my 14, and I'll distribute my 12. 14 times 3 is 42, plus 14 times 3x is 42x, and that's equal to 12 times 4, 48x, plus 12 times 1, 12. Subtracting 42x from both sides, I'll get that 42 is equal to 6x plus 12. And then I'll subtract 12 from both sides to get that 30 is equal to 6x. So my last step in solving for x is to divide by 6. 30 divided by 6 is 5, and 6 divided by 6 is 1, and 1 times x is x. So if I have that x is equal to 5, I'll take that value of 5 and plug it in for my equation for CA. So that'll be 14 plus 3 plus 3 times 5. So that's 14 plus 3 plus 15, since 3 times 5 is equal to 15. 14 plus 3 is 17, and when I add that to 15, I'll get 32. So 32 is my solution in number 14. At number 15, I'm looking at a tangent and a secant intersection. So using that knowledge to solve for the segment length of HG, which is x plus 8. So I'll have my entire secant length, 12 plus 15, over our tangent length, x plus 8, equals the tangent length, x plus 8, over the secant length without the chord, so excluding that 15, which is simply 12. Now I'll cross multiply. So I'll have 12 plus 15 times 12 equals x plus 8, 8 times x plus 8. Now 12 plus 15 is 27. So 27 times 12 will equal x plus 8 times x plus 8, which I can write as x plus 8 squared. So multiplying 27 to 12, I'll get 324, and that's equal to x plus 8 squared. Now I'm going to take the square root of both sides in order to cancel out my exponent on my right. So the square root of 324 is 18. So 18 will be equal to x plus 8. And when I subtract 8 from both sides, I'll get that 10 is equal to x. So knowing that 10 is x, I'm going to plug that value of 10 in for x to find hg. So that will be 10 plus 8, which equals 18. So 18 is my solution in number 15. Also, if you're looking, when I took the square root of 324 and got that 18 was equal to 8 plus x or x plus 8, I could have stopped there because x plus 8, that value is what I'm looking for, which was 18. However, I just did a couple extra steps, solved for x, and then plugged it in. Now, lastly on this worksheet, number 16. Before I go over the answer to 16, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Doing so just lets me know that you're finding these videos useful and encourages me to come out with more videos for you. So feel free to do that now. In number 16, we have an intersection of chords. So a portion of the chord times the remaining portion of that same chord will equal the portion of the other chord times the remaining portion of that other chord. So the length we're looking for is this portion of the chord QS, that portion WS. So segment WS, we can see, is equal to 6X. Now, 6X WS times 12X, that's Q to W, that remaining portion, that's going to equal R to W of 8 times the remaining portion of that other chord, W to P of 9. 6X times 12X is 72X squared, and that's equal to 8 times 9, which is 72. So now I'll divide both sides by 72. So that'll be X squared equal to 72 divided by 72, which is 1. Taking the square root of both sides, the square root of X squared is X, and the square root of 1 is 1. So now I'm going to be taking that value of X, which is 1, and plugging it in for X for WS. So that will be 6 times 1, which equals 6. So the segment WS is equal to 6 in number 16. And with that, I wrap up this worksheet. If you didn't do so already, like, subscribe, and share.